Welcome to AQS Quilt Week Spring Paducah. I am here with Philippa Naylor, the winner of the AccuQuilt Best Miniature Award. Philippa, it is such a pleasure to be here with you. You are teaching for us this week, and it has been an honor to work with you. Can you tell us a little bit about your quilt circuit training?
I can tell you a little bit about it. It's the fourth miniature that I've made, and the first two that I did were whole cloth miniatures, and I decided that I needed to keep challenging myself every time. So the third one was a pre-K or applique, depending on where you come from, and this one is pieced, and so it was a totally different challenge. I think technically it has been the most difficult that I've ever done, but I've already kind of half forgotten what I actually did with it.
How long did it take you to make something like this?
Well, it's usually about 6 to 8 weeks really intensive work, so you know, sewing every day and then sewing late into the night, so maybe 2-3 o'clock in the morning. I have a really busy teaching schedule, so there's a little point in the summertime when I have a few weeks where I can maybe get down to something. I'm not a person that can kind of do a little bit and then leave and then come back. I need to really concentrate on it and sort of work out the design and the technical things in a really quite intensive way.
Sure, yeah. I understand that. I'm the same way. I like to finish something.
Yeah.
So can you tell me a little bit about this quilt? I can tell that it's pieced, and I can tell that you fussy cut a lot of your fabrics there.
Okay, yeah. So shall I point to it? Is that going to make life easier? Okay. So I used a mix of planes, and then I also used some Liberty Lawn fabrics, which are the little prints that you can see there, and they are the ones that were fussy cut. The previous quilt that I had done, which was the applique or applique quilt, had used the Liberty Lawns and discovered that the finer the fabric and the threads, the more detail you can get. So, you know, if you're using a really thick cotton or thick sewing thread, you just can't get the detail. These little bits that I use the Liberty Lawn fabric, they are turned edge applique. And so I had little plastic templates that I gathered the shapes around and then pressed them. So that's how I created those perfect circles. They're probably, well, they're not exactly perfect, but anyway.
They're very close perfect.
Well, they're okay. They are stitched on with free motion machine quilting. So that's when the feed dogs are dropped. And so I am making each stitch the correct length that I want it by just sort of moving the work under the needle. So what I actually think is that my skill at sewing those on is better than the actual free motion quilting skill, because if you wobble with the free motion, you don't really see it. But if you wobble off the edge of a shape, you do really see it. And so sometimes the work has a pattern that I create beforehand, but this one I just started making shapes and then sort of building it up as I went along. So I was creating these little blocks and then just laying them out, working out what background I was going to do, what was going to go where and so on. So, and that's probably quite a lot.
No, that's wonderful. That's perfect. And I've even noticed your tiny little French knots there in the center. Do you have a history of embroidery?
Well, I've always hand sewn. When I was a little girl, I used to just sit and hand sew little dolly's dresses, which is what lots of quilters did. That's how we started. And people always see me as a machine quilter because most of my work is done on a sewing machine, but I absolutely like to do handwork as well, you know. So getting a little bit of some detailing by hand is a nice little finishing off thing. So maybe I'll do more of that in the future. Maybe I'll do a whole handmade quilt one day.
That is your next challenge. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Well, it is truly a stunning quilt.
Thank you.
I understand and I know from experience that this is not your first top award winning quilt. And you've brought some others with us today.
I have. I've got some more to show you. So I've actually got, this is actually the fourth one that I did, as I already mentioned. I'm going to ask you to hold
those.
I'm just going to touch, it's okay, but you can touch it.
Okay.
I don't know whether you can see it, but I'll hold it up. This one is a little autobiographical quilt, and I'm a really keen gardener, so I think it's a really lovely balance between being inside and sewing and then being outside. I really like to be outside. And I have various waterfowl and ducks and things. So I have about 20 chickens and I have a few ducks, and I also have a goose that somebody gave me. There's a long story, but anyway, somebody gave me this saying, this is a little duckling, it can live with your hens, and it transpired that it was a goose.
It was not a duckling, it was a goose.
And he's called Ryan Gosling.
Okay,
so everything is, you know, my trees and everything. I've planted lots of fruit trees. Now, I made this initially for the Festival of Quilts, which is Europe's biggest quilt show. And it's a much smaller size in the miniature category. It's 30 centimetres, whereas it's 24 inches. Now, 30 centimetres is about 12 inches.
Yes.
And I made this exactly 12 inches, and it was disqualified because it was too big.
Oh, no. Oh, and you had done it just right.
Yeah, and because I went 30 centimetres, 12 inches, and it's not quite the same. And when it had failed to do anything because it was disqualified, the head of the judges at the show came and said, well, it would have won first prize, which was £1,000. And so shortly after the show, my husband presented me with this large envelope, which had a certificate in the style of the Festival of Quilts, and it said, to the true winner.
To the true winner. And that is support. That is good.
But the best thing was that there was an envelope with £1,000 in £50 notes. We never see £50 notes, you know, see them. And I said, oh, I can't accept this money, you know, it was my fault. I made a mistake, because I did make a mistake. And I kept it in my bedside table for about 3 months, and then after about 3 months, I thought, oh, yeah, I can have that money.
I can have that money. Yeah. I earned that money.
So I went on, so I'm going to take the one underneath.
Yes, okay.
I then went on to, I'm not sure if I got that, is the right way up?
I think yes.
To do one, shall I give you that one?
Sure,
sorry,
I'll take this
we're
nope,
juggling
we're
here. I went on to do one of the correct size, so that it is, this one is
they
slightly
look
less.
The exact same size,
well,
to me.
There is
so
a little
I don't
bit
know
of
how you were disqualified.
And this is also autobiographical. It's a much softer colour palette, but it has my lovely Bonina sewing machine in the middle there. Just get that Bonina plug in there. And my iron and all my shears, my scissors. And these are all of, not all of my clothes, these are some of my clothes. So some of the clothes that I've made and some that I have bought, and my shoes as well, because I have quite a few pairs of shoes. And fortunately, this was not disqualified.
And then did you win a top prize at that one?
I did. So not at the Festival of Quilts. It did win a prize, but not a top prize. But it came here and it won Best Miniature. And then I have to tell you that it went to Houston and it won a $5,000 award.
Oh, my goodness.
So it did do really well. So having done...
This one I remember from last year.
Yeah, so having... Sorry, I'll give you
I'll
that one back.
I'll take this one.
Okay. So this one is also of the correct size. I did learn something. Having done two whole cloths, then I wanted to try something different. Mm-hmm. And so this is the one that was the turned edge applique. And this one has been a lovely little thing and has done really great things for me. So this one did go to the Festival of Quilts in the UK, mm-hmm. and because it was the correct size, it was not disqualified. Mm-hmm. And it won first place in its category, and then it went on to win Best of Show. So, and then it came here. So these little things that are so tiny.
But they have so much impact,
well,
you know?
I just think it's amazing that something so small can go out and speak so much for you. And
absolutely.
I just think that is actually fantastic. And they've been an absolute pleasure to do, and they're so easy to travel with and store, and you know, they don't cost you a fortune to make
of
them.
Of course, and it's such a thrill to have these here with us today and have you talk about them. And this has really spoken to us, and you can tell, and I think it speaks to everyone who walks by. I want to thank you for talking with me, and I want to thank AccuQuilt for sponsoring this award.
Me too, thank you AccuQuilt, wherever you are. And also, can I just thank everybody here at AQS, because you do such a fantastic job. You make our job so easy as teachers and contestants. So, you know,
honestly,
it doesn't happen, does it?
Well, we are so happy to be here, and we hope you will enter a quilt at the next AQS Quilt Week show.